Hi, in this video, I'll show you how the Data Wrangler extension for Visual Studio Code is the perfect tool for data exploration and data cleaning. This is Vincent Codes Finance, a channel about coding for finance research. If you're interested in that topic, please subscribe. So first things first, we'll need to install the Data Wrangler extension. For that, you can go to your extension tab, then search for Data Wrangler. I already have it installed, but here it's the Data Wrangler extension by Microsoft. Make sure you install it. And once you have it, it's ready. So there's two ways that you can load your data with Data Wrangler. The first way, if you go here in your file explorer, so say here I've got a CSV file, I can right click on it and open it in Data Wrangler. But that's not quite what I want, because then you'd have to select your runtime and configure it. That's not kind of the way I use it. So the way I prefer to use it is inside of a Jupyter notebook, because I don't want to only explore. Once I'm done exploring and cleaning, I want to keep track of all the steps that I've done. And for that, I need code. So the integration with the Jupyter notebook is really good. By the way, I don't tend to use Jupyter notebooks that much in my data analysis workflow. I really prefer pure Python scripts. They work better with Git. It's just cleaner code, easier to test and everything. But for the specific task of data exploration, I think that Jupyter notebooks are great for that step of my workflow. And once I'm done, then I copy all my code into a pure Python script. So the Data Wrangler integration with Jupyter notebooks is pretty great for that workflow. So let's go in my Jupyter notebook. So here I've got a simple Jupyter notebook. I've got an environment with just the bare bones, so Pandas and Jupyter. The data I'll be using, you can get it from this link. It's also in the video description. So it's a Kaggle data set of Kickstarter projects. So projects for kind of ideas or start that people were trying to get funding for. So let me just load Pandas. And then I would just load the CSV as I would do normally. And that's pretty much it. So now if I say go here in my variables, let me close the terminal. So I've got a data frame here. I typically had the data frame explorer, but now if I click on it, Data Wrangler is going to take over. Right? So I can open my data frame like this. I can also open it just here. If you look at view data, it's going to list the data frame that it has. I can click on it and then it will open also my data frame. So I'll close one of them because I don't want to run out of memory. Although that data says not too large, actually what Data Wrangler does when you open your data frame, it makes a copy. So it's never working on your actual data. It's working on a copy of the data until you're happy with it. And the first view that Data Wrangler provides is very good. It's just a list of all the columns. So here, see all the columns in my data set. And for all the numerical columns, we'll see, we'll get some information, right? So for the numerical columns, we'll get a histogram of the different values. For every column, we'll get a kind of list of distinct values, number of distinct values, number of missing values for all of them. So that's pretty good. If you've got here, say a category, so it's detected as an object in the data frame, it's just a string, but because it only has 15 distinct values, a Data Wrangler kind of figures out that you might be, maybe you care about the distribution of these values. So it's going to give you a breakdown. So 59% is other, but the three main categories would be film and video, music and publishing. Same thing for currencies. So it's like the others, it's only 8%, right? So because 78% are in USD, 9% in pounds and 5% in euros, and yeah, the rest is 8%. So that's already pretty good information that you get. Again, with the state, it's also get the breakdown. Everything numerical, you'll get a histogram. Depending if you get big outliers, then the histogram doesn't look that good, but that's what you get out of the box. So say I would just click on that main category column, then on the left-hand side here in that sidebar, what I get a bit more information. So this column is not numerical, so I don't get much more information. But if I was to say go here in a say goal column, which is numerical, then I get the mean, standard deviation, minimums, all the kind of descriptive stats that you'd care about when you look at that, plus even advanced statistics such as kurtosis and skew. So that's great for looking at the data, but obviously there are kind of things that maybe I'd want to filter out or kind of take care of, or things like that. So for example, here, say I only wanted to keep the successful campaign, I could add a filter here, state where it's equal to, and then I would say maybe successful, and then I can add that filter here. So as you see, I've got a live preview. If I'm happy with that, then I can just leave it. Okay, so now I've got only the successful ones. So this is what they call the viewing mode, which lets you filter, but it's a bit limited in terms of what you can do. The real power is when you go to the editing mode, which lets you clean and edit with your data with the built-in operation that you have there in the Data Wrangler. So here you say it says like it's converted to editing mode. Do you want Data Wrangler to open in editing mode by default? I think I'll set it to yes, because typically I want to clean a bit of the data before I care about viewing the actual statistics. So this is pretty good. Okay, so I'll set that to this. And then in this mode, you can actually edit your data in operations. So you'll just apply different operations. And for each operations, as you'll see, the Data Wrangler extension will show you a preview of the effect and then will generate the Pandas code to apply that transformation. So there are different types of transformations. For example, here we've got the deadline column. It's a date column, but as we see here, it's detected as an object, so it hasn't been detected as a date time. So here, we can go here, we can sort, filter, but that rename, drop, change the column to kind of type. And that's pretty much what we want here, right? So we want to change the column type from object to here, maybe a date time. So when we do that, before I even do that transformation, as you see, we'll get a kind of a diff. We'll get a preview of the output. And here, as we see, it seems to have detected the date format properly. So if I'm happy with that, then I can apply. And in the preview, not only do I get the preview of the transformation here, I also get the preview of the code that will be applied. So I'm happy with that. I'll apply. I won't take the survey now. No, thanks. And now we see that this operation has been added to our list of cleaning steps. So first we'll load the data from variables. So that's kind of, that was the first step initially when we just initially loaded the data. Then we filtered based on the state. Then we changed the column type. And now that's where we are in our cleaning step. And by the way, if you made any mistake, you can always go back. You can always delete one step, or you can go back and change it. So this is pretty cool when you're doing some data cleaning. So here I'm happy with this one. Now I'll go to my next operation. So if I look at my columns here, none of them are missing any values except this one, USD pledge. So if I was going to use this in my analysis and I want to drop the missing values, well, I can do it right directly from here, but I can actually come here and then use one of these operations to clean my data. So for example, here I could go into find and replace and drop the missing values for this column. Again, what it's gonna do is gonna show me what it's gonna look like. So I'm kind of dropping a few values here. The code here would be this one. I'm happy with that. I can apply and then it would drop these observations from my sample. So I won't go into all of these operations, but you can, you have operation to drop duplicates, filling missing values, do some find and replace for formatting text, date strings, and things like that. You also have a few formulas for either encoding categories or doing one-hot encoders and things like that that can be used after that for either regression or machine learning steps. There are some numerical operations for scaling, rounding, things like that. You have operations For schema, so either changing the column type, column names, things like that. And you have operations for sorting and filtering. You also have custom operation where you can enter your own code for one step of the operation if you want. Obviously, you don't want to be doing all of that all the time. Otherwise, you'd rather be in just Jupyter Notebook. But if there's kind of one or two steps in your cleaning for which you don't have a built-in operation, then you can add it here manually. They also have group by and aggregate. I'll come back to that in a minute. But one thing I want to show first is the new column by example. It's actually pretty cool. So say here, if I go back again to my deadline here, and I go to new column by example, based on the deadline, I'll have a derived column. Suppose I wanted a column that only has the year in that column. I'm not quite sure how to do it. It's not one of the built-in functions that I've seen or that I know. Well, I can just go and provide one example here. Then it's going to kind of try to infer what you want to do. And here, as you've seen, it kind of detected what I want to do. So far, all the little things that I've tried have worked pretty well. So this is kind of pretty cool. So here we'll call it year. And now if I'm happy with that, we'll see kind of this is the code that it generated. It kind of detected what I wanted to do. This is amazing. I'm not sure how it works under the hood, whether they have some machine learning working for that, but this is pretty cool. So I'll just apply. Now I've got a new column with the year. Okay, and now let's go into the group by. So now that we've got the year, maybe we want to group by year. So here I could go here into group by and aggregate. So suppose here I want to group by. Now I will kind of decide what do I want to do. So now I'm grouping by year and I need to add some aggregations. So suppose what I wanted to do was to look at the USD pledge column that I cared about. We'll see that we have some missing values by group there for some of the years, but that's okay. But for some of these years, we do have a lot of values. So suppose that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to get the average USD pledge per year. So I could go here, select the column, the USD pledge, and then you can have count or you can have different values. So all the kind of typical operation. So here, for example, if I care about the mean, again, I get my preview and then I can apply. And here I'll get a kind of new summarized data set for which I've got for all the years, the mean USD pledge in my data set. So that is pretty good. Suppose this is what I wanted in the end. And now I'm happy with all my operations. What I can do is I can go in here, either export as a file, which I don't want to do. I don't want to export my data as a file. I want to keep the code, right? Because I want to keep track of all my operations. So you can either copy all the code or export it back to your notebook, right? So this is the notebook where I had the data. And then what it did, it added all the code necessary to repeat all my operations in one function called clean data. And what it does is call my clean data function using a copy of my data frame. And if I kind of just rerun my notebook here, what we'll see is that I get the cleaned output there, but it's not only the output, I have the code to repeat and replicate everything that I've done. So far, I really like the tool. I think it's really great. There are kind of just a few things that I think are missing for me to make it perfect for my workflow. So first, there's no built-in log transformation, which to me, it's common. It's in finance research, it's kind of the most common operation probably that we'll do after dropping missing values. And I'd like also if we have kind of the automated kind of winsorize function, things like that, it's not there. It's not a big deal. You can always do it manually, but this would be really nice if we'd have that built-in transformation right in Data Wrangler. The other big downside that I see is with respect to where Pandas is heading. So I've shown in one of my previous video how the Pi Arrow backend, which is now one of the option in Pandas 2, is actually much faster. Plus, it's compatible with a wide array of other third-party tools that also work with the PyArrow memory model. So for me now, in any new projects, I try to use the PyArrow D-type backend as much as I can. And Data Wrangler doesn't quite support it yet. So if we go back here in our code, and instead of using read CSV as we typically do, if I had used the PyArrow engine and the PyArrow D-type backend, now the data set is going to load super quickly. So here we have our data frame. It seems to be good. I can even look at our information. We see that everything has been detected properly. Even the dates and timestamps have been detected properly. If we open it now in Data Wrangler, what we see is that everything, including the kind of dates, so for example here, deadline, still detected as a date, 32-day PyArrow, but it's not treated as a date in Data Wrangler because it is a PyArrow type and it doesn't really support the PyArrow type neatly. Even here, if we go to numerical values like this, so goal here, it is a double, it's a PyArrow data format. So even if I go here, we'll see that we'll get the warning that this data type is not fully supported. It's going to have limited statistic information. It does provide me the statistics, but it doesn't have the kurtosis, the skew. It doesn't kind of support everything that it does with the kind of built-in type. And you don't get the kind of icons here with the which lets you kind of figure out visually what all of these data types are. I'm sure that's something that I'll be working on in the future, but it's not there yet. That being said, overall, I think that Data Wrangler is a pretty neat tool for exploring new data set and making sure that you've cleaned them properly and that you kept track of all your steps. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and also consider subscribing so that you get notified of my future videos.